2023 could be one of the most eventful years in VR history with the release of the best VR headset the industry has to offer. We'll take a deeper dive into each upcoming headset, either officially confirmed or rumored headsets that we can confidently expect this year in 2023. We have so many headsets to cover, so let's get right into it. If you're either in the VR community or the Apple community, the chances are you have heard about more rumors and leaks of the upcoming VR headset from Apple. Apple has been working on a mixed reality headset for many years now, but according to very reliable sources, the headset will finally hit the shelves this year. You know Apple. They're actually rather late to whatever technology party, but when they put their mind and effort into it, they come out with an almost perfect device for its time. Apple will most likely be calling the headset Reality Pro, and the announcement event is expected to be in the spring. So it's not that far away from whenever you're watching this video.
Your Mac friend, Brent Rambo.
The official release of the headset is expected to be sometime in the fall timeframe, and Apple has already sent different prototypes to high-profile software developers to test their apps on their headset. The headset will weigh somewhere around 300 to 400 grams, which is lighter than Oculus Quest 2 for reference. Just something to note, I do call this a VR headset, but Apple will put a lot of focus in its AR capabilities as well. The device will feature an OLED 4K display made by Sony, including eye tracking, more than 12 cameras and sensors, automatic IPD adjustments, and 120 degrees of field of view, which is massive compared to the industry standard. These are just the top level overview of the headset, and there will be so many advanced features that will be part of the headset as well. All of the hardware specs will be supported by Apple's most advanced M2 chip, which could make the Reality Pro the most powerful VR headset currently on the market. It is no surprise, as you'll be paying a fortune for this headset. The leaked price is somewhere between $2,000 to $3,000, so you won't be seeing this headset too often in the consumer's hands. Regardless, Apple will be setting the bar high as they enter a new market. Ever since October of last year, HTC has been showing teasers of their upcoming standalone VR headset for consumers. HTC did reveal their newest headset, Vive XR Elite, during CES 2023. When you first look at this headset, there's nothing special to it that stands out. As you see in this picture, this is a special feature unique to the Vive XR Elite, as the battery on the back of the headset can now be removed, turning the headset into a lighter VR glasses type of device. The purpose of this feature would be to enjoy a VR experience all while lying down, which is a very uncomfortable experience on traditional VR headsets. The headset will be a little bit heavier than what we're used to, and even though HTC only confirmed a few of its specs, we know through leaks that it'll most likely have a 1920 by 1920 pixels per eye and 110 degrees of field of view. One of HTC's biggest focuses with the Vive XR Elite is the video pass-through quality. The headset is equipped with a full color pass-through as well as a depth sensor to give you a better experience in mixed reality. The headset will have popular VR games natively to its headset to also put in efforts outside of productive uses and video streaming. The headset is definitely something new, as we haven't seen any headset on the market that can turn into lightweight mode, but it will cost you $1,099, which will turn off a lot of consumers. If you're interested, you can pre-order the headset now, and it will be shipped sometime in the second half of February. Originally funded through a Kickstarter campaign, Lynx R1 promises to offer a mixed reality experience that seems similar to Quest Pro with almost half of its price. This headset was originally supposed to be shipped out back in April of 2022, but we finally heard from the developers that they are ready to ship sometime in February. The resolution of the headset is somewhat on the lower side compared to the others on this list, coming in at dual 1600 by 1600. The VR side is nothing insane, but they do claim that their AR capabilities are the best in their field. From their website, they seem to focus on two things, which are video pass-through with zero latency and the huge focus on its privacy, even calling out Facebook. What's really interesting about this headset is that their 6 degrees of freedom controllers are sold separately, and they use hand tracking as their primary mode of interaction. The hand tracking technology on even the Quest 2 is really good, but I could never use hand tracking as my main source of interaction. So when it comes to Lynx R1, I actually have high expectations for their hand tracking technology. As mentioned earlier, the headset will be released sometime in February and will be sold at $849, while the controllers that are sold separately are expected to be launched in the third quarter of 2023. Mark Zuckerberg is calling this the next generation of our Quest headset for consumers, as well as calling it the successor to Oculus Quest 2 by other executives.
Another one.
Of course, we're talking about Meta / Oculus Quest 3. The name Quest 3 is not officially confirmed by Meta, but we're all talking about the same headset, which is confirmed to release at some point in the future, with all leaks calling for a 2023 release. The bigger focus with Quest 3 will be on mixed reality. You do see a trend with mostly all VR manufacturers that they'll be putting a lot of effort into the overall mixed reality experience, vice just the VR experience, which I know is the best for consumers as well as prosumers. As of this point, the rumored release will be sometime in the fall, and my personal take is that they will align the release with Meta Connect, which is hosted every October, so something very similar to how Meta Quest Pro was released. The hardware specs are pretty much what they call it, a successor to Quest 2. Meta will include more advanced features that Quest 2 didn't have, like the pancake lenses and the full color pass-through. Quest 3 will still have the cheap fabric head strap seen on Quest 2, but I do think this is a good thing rather than a bad thing. You can see from the leaked CAD files that the head strap will have a connection point to the strap, pretty much the same ones we see on Quest 2, which means the players will be able to customize their headset with upgraded head straps to make it much more comfortable on their head. Mark Zuckerberg indicated a possible price range of $300 to $500, just like the Quest 2. If they're able to stay within the expected price range, I do believe that Quest 3 will be the most sold VR headset next year. PlayStation VR will be one of, if not the most immersive VR experience that will be available this February. At this point, we pretty much know everything about PSVR 2 as it has been officially announced for around a year and players were able to interact with it firsthand at different conferences. This time around, Sony will keep the cabling to a minimum, include high-spec dedicated VR controllers, and cover the shortfalls of its first version of PSVR released back in 2016. You can expect pretty much everything you can want from a modern VR headset. It will have two 4K OLED displays, 110 degrees of field of view, eye tracking, foveated rendering, and a haptic system to immerse the player into the VR world. The headset will be released on February 22nd with pre-orders available now for $550. My first take on PSVR 2 was that since you have to purchase the PS5 plus the headset, you'll be paying somewhere around $1,000, so I was iffy on the price. Later, I was enlightened by the VR community on Reddit that since the PS5 will be acting as the PC to play high quality games, it's actually much cheaper than buying a high spec gaming PC plus the PC VR compatible headset. I do understand PSVR 2 will be different than PC VR in terms of the experience and the game selection, but it did open my eyes to a different perspective that justified the price Sony is offering. This next one is a promising PC VR headset with very promising specs while keeping it super lightweight at only 320 grams, which is about 11 ounces.
Who's that Pokemon?
The headset is called MeganeX, and it is a PC VR headset made by a Japanese company. I only point that out because Megane in Japanese means glasses to bring focus to its ultra-compact design. The headset did see many delays during its production cycle, but we'll finally be able to get our hands on it sometime between March and April. The headset's resolution is a beast, coming in at 2560 by 2560 pixels per eye, micro OLED display to include pancake lenses. The downfall of the device is its inability to have a standalone wireless PC VR experience, which I don't think is that big of a deal, than the headset costing $1,699. I also want to point out that they're working on pretty cool VR accessories to include the MuTalk, a Bluetooth accessory worn over the mouth that suppresses noise, which is useful if you play VR games that you need to talk but can't due to place you live in or time of the day. Other ones include Flip VR, a controller that you can flip the controller buttons to the outside of your hands, which frees up your hand to take a drink or even type on the keyboard. Hiritora X is a full body tracking device strapped to your stomach, so the company is involved in many aspects of VR and could be a prominent player in the future of VR. Somnium VR was presented at CES 2023, made by the social VR startup Somnium Space. This PC VR headset is targeted at the VR enthusiast as well as the modders or anyone that likes to have total control of their device. The company states their two main focus with their headset, which are open source character and modularity. So basically, reading the explanation provided by the company, the device is a PC VR headset that you can change, add, or modify many parts of the headset, as well as giving access to advanced users to create custom VR and mixed reality apps. And they're not lying about the high specs part I just mentioned. The headset will have a 2880 by 2880 display, 120 horizontal, 100 vertical FOVs, Wi-Fi 6E, a wireless standalone PC VR experience, which will be released at a later time, and many other features. This sounds all good and cool for the VR enthusiasts out there, but the one thing that scares me is that the price still remains a mystery. I don't think this is a good sign, so if you're interested, let's just hope that it'll be in a reasonable price range. Alright, this next VR headset? No, it's more like VR glasses, is for any readers out there. Maybe there aren't too many people that read that are watching this video, so I'll make it really quick. This is the Soul Reader VR glasses, and it's like having Kindle in VR. The great thing about this is that you can browse and read ebooks lying down without holding a device like Kindle. There is a small controller that you can use to turn the pages, and the device is even equipped with pancake lenses to support its compact design. It weighs less than a quarter of a pound, and it is expected to have a battery life of about 30 hours. I would love to have a design like this as I read pretty much every day.
Stop the cap!
But according to Brad Lynch, who is a famous VR YouTuber, the resolution still has some room for improvement. This e-reader has no official release date as of yet, but the company wants to charge around $350 for the device. The next three headsets we'll be talking about are unconfirmed, but there is a stronger case for release than not. The first of these headsets is the Pico 5. There is the least amount of information available on this headset, but as the next generation of Snapdragon XR chip, the Gen 2 is available and will be part of the Quest 3, it only makes sense for Pico to integrate the new chip for a more powerful device. There were rumors that began floating around December of last year after a Korean news portal covered Samsung's plan to tap into the VR industry with a mixed reality dev kit sometime this year. Samsung CEO has previously stated that Samsung is working hard on a metaverse device. Just like the Pico 5, there isn't too much information available at this point, but looking at Samsung's track record in the technology sector, I could see them producing a very high-tech VR device as well as being a prominent player in the game. When you think of PC VR, the first headset that comes to my mind, as well as many others' minds, is the Valve Index. Valve Index was released back in 2019, but still remains one of the best PC VR headsets. Now, as some time has passed by, there were reliable leaks that confirmed that Valve is working on a prototype device with the codename Deckard. This new headset from Valve is expected to be at least partial or even fully standalone PC VR headset. Nonetheless, we know that something is going on at Valve, so we can see if some VR leakers can get more information on this headset. VR hardware isn't the only thing exciting coming out in 2023. Here are the top 50 upcoming VR games getting released in 2023.